Welcome to an overview of some of the changes you can expect to see in Desire to Learn version 10.3, brought to you by UWM's Learning Technology Center. Please keep in mind that this is just a sneak peek. More detailed help documentation will be available under Need Help Using D2L on your D2L My homepage. One of the most significant changes coming in D2L 10.3 is to the discussions area. The redesign of the discussions tool is intended to lead to more focused discussions and fewer clicks. So, when you click into a discussion topic, you will be able to start a new thread, and you will see a list of existing discussion threads if any have been posted. In this case, each thread is a student's original or first post, and by clicking on its title, you can read the string of replies within it and post your own response as well. In addition to the new look and feel in discussions, D2L 10.3 brings with it a new rating system for discussions. So, you will be able to give all participants the ability to provide quick plus and minus ratings for discussion postings. This plus-minus rating system is in addition to the existing 5-star rating system. As an instructor, you can then see the overall ratings for each discussion thread. In D2L 10.3, users can navigate more easily between documents in the Content Document Viewer. When you click on a content topic, you will see an arrow along the left of the document viewer. By clicking on that arrow, you can bring up a navigation menu for a particular module. You can then select different items or topics within that module, or even move between modules by clicking on the arrows near the top. In D2L 10.3, the navigation for quiz creation has changed a bit, so you want to look for the old buttons just in new places. For example, you will add edit questions directly on the Properties tab, and you can link the quiz to the gradebook, mark it to be graded automatically, and set the number of attempts, all on the new Assessment tab. Do you regularly download student Dropbox assignments, mark them up in Microsoft Word, and then re-upload those documents into the Dropbox? If so, then the ability to bulk upload feedback in D2L 10.3 could be a real time saver for you. After you have downloaded student files and provided feedback in those files, then you simply need to click Add Feedback Files in the Dropbox folder, and they will be distributed to each student's feedback area all at once. Each student's submission has a unique identifier, so you just need to keep the document name the same after you initially download them. On rare occasions, students don't turn in their assignments like they're supposed to. If you collect assignments in the D2L Dropbox, then leaving feedback for these non-submissions can take a few extra clicks. However, in D2L 10.3, the ability to evaluate non-submissions in Dropbox can significantly help streamline the grading process, as you can provide grades and comments to all students, whether they've submitted anything or not, directly in the Dropbox area. In D2L 10.3, you can now bring back both deleted Dropbox folders and deleted discussion modules and topics with a few simple clicks. When restored, these items will contain any student submissions and postings as well. The role switch tool is moving. In previous versions of D2L, you would look for the role switch widget on the course homepage if you wanted to see your course from a student's perspective. In D2L 10.3, you will just need to click on your name in the minibar and click on View as Student. You can also see the course from the perspective of other roles by clicking on Change and selecting the appropriate role. Thank you for viewing our video on D2L version 10.3. If you have any questions, please feel free to contact us at the Learning Technology Center.